Welcome, my dear friends, to this second lecture on antinatural and unscientific hypothesis. I discussed about the ultimate substratum of all created beings and things called universe in my first lecture on antinatural and unscientific hypothesis. I also discussed about Sirius binary system or binary star system, four basic fields, four basic forces, four cardinal directions of helium 4 atom, white dwarf companion Sirius B and Sirius A of Sirius binary system in my first lecture on antinatural and unscientific hypothesis. In resemblance with the separate sheet of the global scientific community and in correspondence to reality. I also discussed about antinatural and unscientific hypotheses such as solar universe or solar system of antinatural scientists and black and white activists in my first lecture on antinatural and unscientific hypothesis, producing references of concealed scientific names and scientific character codes of global scientific community. My dear friends, today I shall try to share with you Sirius A or East Horizon or gravitational field of the upright rectangular universe, immovable hexagonal world, planet Pluto within the east horizon, appearing pentagonal earth like 9/11 pentagon with three ascending stars within the east horizon or gravitational field of the upright rectangular universe. Two zones, Eastern Daylight Time Zone and Western Daylight Time Zone. Six manifested regions, upright west region of the appointed Kaaba and straight Middle East region of Artha 3D, etc., in resemblance with the separate sheet of the global scientific community and in correspondence to reality mentioned in page 27 of our National Curriculum Framework 2005. I have prepared 57 slides on antinatural and unscientific hypothesis. This slide is giving you information regarding 57 slides of my 7 lectures on antinatural and unscientific hypothesis, as well as references of formal grounds and legitimate grounds of my 7 lectures on antinatural and unscientific hypothesis. World has been manifested within the east horizon or Sirius A or gravitational field of the upright rectangular universe as a hexagon. This is the hexagonal world. Six manifested regions and unit hex are the scientific proofs of the manifested hexagonal world. Manifested hexagonal world is called planet Pluto. There are elliptical barriers between white dwarf companion Sirius B and Sirius A of the Sirius binary system. These elliptical barriers are called canopies. Global scientists have recognized 7 elliptical canopies as Windows 7 Ultimate. Manifested hexagonal world or planet Pluto appears as if a global world due to elliptical canopies or elliptical windows between white dwarf companion Sirius B and Sirius A of the Sirius binary system. Manifested hexagonal world is called Star of David. It is called Star of David or asterisk. Manifested hexagonal world has two zones, East zone or lower seashore and West zone or upper seashore, East zone and West zone. There is a peg of the manifested hexagonal world toward straight Middle East region of Artha 3D. There is a peg of the manifested hexagonal world towards straight Middle East region of Artha 3D. This peg of the manifested hexagonal world resembles the root of a tree. This peg of the manifested hexagonal world towards straight Middle East region of Artha 3D is called planet Mars. Planet Mars. Manifested hexagonal world within the east horizon is not moving due to planet Mars or straight Middle East region of Artha 3D. We are living in an immovable hexagonal world or planet Pluto or Star of David within the east horizon or gravitational field of the upright rectangular universe. Root of a tree is not found in appearance. Similarly, the peg of the manifested hexagonal world or Artha 3D is not found in appearance. So, the manifested hexagonal world is appearing as a pentagonal earth like 9/11 Pentagon. Manifested hexagonal world is appearing as a pentagonal earth like 9/11 Pentagon. The architect of 9/11 Pentagon is the historical dawn of two-in-one partnership between terrorism and activism. The architect of 9/11 Pentagon is the mastermind of 9/11 suicide game and current silent killing or bioterrorism. In this connection, I had placed one self-explanatory grievance petition of 291 pages before Secretary General of United Nations on the 5th May 2020. You will find references of my self-explanatory grievance petition in pages 577 to 611 of my book UNO's Contributions, published by Notion Press 2020. There is no such weapon or power in the equal and opposite hand of the architect of 9/11 Pentagon or the historical dawn of terrorism and activism, on the basis of which his scientific terrorists and black and white activists are able to face searched out verifiable framework and justifiable curriculum of natural science and contents of my 7 lectures on anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis. The architect of 9/11 Pentagon is able to take my present life or to harass my family members. However, the architect of 9/11 Pentagon or the historical dawn of two-in-one partnership between terrorists and activists or the historical dawn of two-in-one Laden or equal and opposite father and mother of terrorism and activism is absolutely unable to conceal the immovable hexagonal world or planet Pluto or Star of David appearing as a pentagonal earth like 9/11 Pentagon with three ascending stairs within the east horizon of the or the gravitational field or Sirius A of the upright rectangular universe from conscience of blessed human persons and upright logic of my dear students. Possessors of balanced good sense and my dear students are able to draw the line of demarcation or Lakshman Rekha between uncontradicted facts of this equal and opposite manifested nature such as immovable hexagonal world or planet Pluto appearing as a pentagonal earth like 9/11 Pentagon with three ascending stairs within the east horizon of the upright rectangular universe and projected and communicated anti-natural and unscientific hypotheses such as running global world and moving global earth within the running and moving solar universe. The architect of 9/11 Pentagon and his cultured terrorists, civilized activists, intellectual criminals, conscious conspirators, manifest hypocrites, teleological evidence sorcerers, extreme epistemic persecutors, propagators of the nexus of anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis, educated idiots, highly qualified frauds, epistemic liars, falsehood mongers, self-certified traitors, and media persons of global concerns do not have any authority over conscience of blessed human persons and upright logic of my dear students. My dear friends, if you desire to acquire unerring knowledge, verifiable and justifiable from all perspectives or disciplines, then you will have to do nothing save to unlock your upright logic or common sense. If you unlock your epistemic sense, like so-called epistemic persons, then the contents of my 7 lectures on anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis will appear before you as if good collection of conjectures of a madman or a bad man. It will be better for you if you avoid my 7 lectures on anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis. Manifested hexagonal world or planet Pluto has two zones. East zone and west zone. The line of demarcation between east zone and west zone is called equator or danger. Two ends of the equator are North Pole and South Pole. North Pole of the equator is called E point or aphelion. South pole of the equator is called T point or perihelion. E point or North pole represents natural north direction and magnetic field or northern hemisphere. T point or South pole represents natural south direction and weak field or southern hemisphere. Two zones of the manifested hexagonal world resemble two seashores. Lower seashore of the manifested hexagonal world is called east zone, and the upper seashore of the manifested hexagonal world is called west zone. Region of the tallest tree of Newton. Region of the tallest tree of Newton or the appointed Kaaba is the manifested sign of the upper seashore or west zone. Region of the Artha 3D at the center and junction of the seas is the manifested sign of the lower seashore or east zone. There is only one stair in the lower seashore or east zone. There are two stairs in the upper seashore or west zone. So there are three ascending stairs in the appearing pentagonal earth like 9/11 pentagon. Three ascending stairs of the appearing pentagonal earth or manifested hexagonal world are ground stair of the lower seashore. This ground stair of the lower seashore is called Kepler's minor axis. This line is representing Kepler's minor axis. Middle stair of the upper seashore. Middle stair of the upper seashore is called Kepler's semi-major axis. This stair is called Kepler's semi-major axis. And the mountaintop stair of the upper seashore or west zone is called Kepler's major axis. So there are three ascending stairs: ground stair, middle stair, mountaintop stair. Kepler's minor axis, Kepler's semi-major axis, and Kepler's major axis. Superscript 1, superscript 2, and superscript 3. There is an even and odd contrast like H2O in the manifested hexagonal world appearing as a pentagonal earth like 9/11 pentagon with three ascending stairs within the east horizon of the upright rectangular universe. That is, two stairs of the upper seashore, two stairs of the upper seashore, and one stair of the lower seashore. Manifested hexagonal world has six regions. There are three regions in the east zone or lower seashore. Three regions of the east zone or lower seashore are northeast region of North America, straight middle east region of Artha 3D, and southeast region of South America. Straight middle east region of
Artha 3D is the peg of the manifested world or planet Pluto within the east horizon of the upright rectangular universe. Manifested world or planet Pluto is not moving due to straight middle east region of Artha 3D.
There are three regions in the west zone or upper seashore. Three regions of the west zone or upper seashore are southwest region of Africa, Asia and Australia, upright west region of Arabian Peninsula and northwest region of Europe. Upright west region of Arabian Peninsula is the Leaning Tower of Galileo. Upright west region of Arabian Peninsula is the Leaning Tower of Galileo. Straight Middle East region of Artha 3D and upright west region of the appointed Kaaba, straight Middle East region of Artha 3D and upright west region of the appointed Kaaba are the equal and opposite regions of the manifested hexagonal world. Equal and opposite regions of the manifested hexagonal world or planet Pluto within the east horizon of the upright rectangular universe. Middle dot is the straight middle east region of Artha 3D towards space bar or oily table of Newton. It is called planet Mars. It is the peg of the immovable hexagonal world. This is the immovable hexagonal world. Leaning Tower of Galileo is the upright west region of the appointed Kaaba, or a table spread with fruits from the west horizon, or region of the Mount Tur. This is the region of the Mount Tur above middle stair of the west zone, over water or straight middle east region of Artha 3D and above ground stair of the east zone. Planet Mars, this is the planet Mars or penetrated region of the immovable hexagonal world or planet Pluto. Three regions of the west zone and three regions of the east zone. Towards planet Mars or straight middle east region of Artha 3D. Immovable hexagonal world has six manifested regions. Straight middle east region of Artha 3D as the peg of the immovable world is not found in appearance. So, the manifested hexagonal world or planet Pluto is appearing as a pentagonal earth like 9/11 pentagon or spider's net or house or star operator. Appearing earth is called spider's net or house or star operator. Global scientists have named the appearing pentagonal earth like 9/11 pentagon as star operator. This is the star operator. Star operator is a pentagonal star. There is a difference between a star and a star operator. A star is like a diamond, that is a four-figured star or a quadrilateral star. A star operator is a pentagon, like appearing pentagonal earth or 9/11 pentagon. It is certain, like my existence as a finite rational being, that our earth is a pentagon. Appearing earth is a pentagon. You just try to recognize your existence in this appearing pentagonal earth. Here is northeast region of North America, here southeast region of South America, here southwest region of Asia, Africa and Australia, here northwest region of Europe, and here upright west region of Arabian Peninsula. Similarly, you just try to recognize your existence in this appearing pentagonal earth. Here you will find that appearing pentagonal earth within the east horizon or black square of the upright rectangular universe. Appearing pentagonal earth within the east horizon or black square of the upright rectangular universe. Appearing pentagonal earth is called house. Now, it is being taught that the appearing pentagonal earth resembles an orange lemon or Komla lebu. There is nothing like orange lemon or Komla lebu. However, you just reflect on this orange lemon or Komla lebu, you will find that this orange lemon or Komla lebu is a pentagon, like 9/11 pentagon or spider's net or house or star operator of global scientific community. Here is northeast region of North America. Here is southeast region of South America. Here is southwest region of Asia, Africa and Australia. Here is northwest region of Europe, and here upright west region of Arabian Peninsula. So this Komla lebu is being appeared as a pentagon, like 9/11 pentagon or our appearing earth or spider's net or star operator or house. Now reflect on these pentagons, pentagonal stars. And sincerely reflect on this pentagon, you will find here the stages of journey of the so-called sun, northeast region of North America, southeast region of South America, southwest region of Asia, Africa, Australia, upright west region of Arabian Peninsula, and northwest region of Europe. In this slide, you just try to understand three ascending stairs: ground stair, middle stair, and mountaintop stair of the appearing pentagonal earth, like 9/11 pentagon. Ground stair, northeast region of North America and southeast region of South America. Middle stair, southwest region of Africa, Asia, Australia and northwest region of Europe. Mountaintop stair, upright west region of Arabian Peninsula. You also try to recognize planet Mars or Artha 3D. here you will find octagonal matter particle, octagonal matter particle. Now reflect on these two, it is called star. A star is a quadrilateral or four figured diagram, and it is called pentagon. This pentagon is our appearing pentagonal earth, appearing pentagonal earth. North America, South America, Asia, Africa, Australia, Arabian Peninsula and Europe. My dear friends, try to recognize immovable hexagonal world or Star of David within the east horizon of the upright rectangular universe. Peg of the immovable hexagonal world or planet Mars or straight Middle East region of Artha 3D towards black hole. Equal and opposite, straight Middle East region of Artha 3D and upright west region of the appointed Kaaba. Straight Middle East region of Artha 3D and upright west region of the appointed Kaaba. Straight Middle East region of Artha 3D and upright west region of the appointed Kaaba. Star operator of the global scientific community. Pentagonal Earth, northeast region of North America, southeast region of South America, southwest region of Africa, Asia, Australia, northwest region of Europe, and upright west region of Arabian Peninsula. Now try to understand the equal and opposite game of conspiracy and hypocrisy, that is concealment of the appearing pentagonal earth like 9/11 Pentagon and projection of unreal such as universally accepted moving global earth of an antinatural community as if real. Equal and opposite, appearing pentagonal earth and universally accepted global earth. Two contradictories or rival hypotheses, such as universe is a solar system and universe is a Sirius binary system, cannot be true together or false together from the point of view of four fundamental categories of knowledge, such as space, time, substance, and causality. The truth of one, such as universe is a solar system, categorically implies the falsity of the other, such as universe is a Sirius binary system, and conversely. If it is recognized and confirmed that our universe is a solar system, then it will manifest clearly that Sirius binary system is nothing but a conjecture of Jameer Ahmed Chowdhury. If it is recognized and confirmed that our universe is a Sirius binary system, then it will prove, removing all doubts, that projected solar universe or solar system is an antinatural and unscientific hypothesis within the framework and curriculum of natural science.
These are infallible and unerring mandates or verifiable scientific codes and justifiable logical rules. Man-made constitution, UN Universal Declaration, mutual understanding, unanimous agreement, global policy, autonomy of global science, SDG, so far established laws, rules, regulations, guidelines, parameters, uncountable science books and science journals, innumerable research works, fatwas of Islamic scholars and Muslim leaders, comments of the eminent experts, munkibat of eminent persons, etc., do not have any authority over these infallible and unerring mandates or verifiable scientific codes and justifiable logical rules. It is the constitutional duty and moral responsibility of the concerned ministers and respective authorities to the government to provide us recognized confirmation of one of the contradictories as unerring knowledge or ensured quality education. Simultaneously, it is also the duty for duty's sake of the concerned ministers and respective authorities to the government to take necessary steps with a view to erase anti-natural and unscientific hypotheses from the framework and curriculum of natural science. It is my assigned constitutional duty and moral responsibility as a teacher to communicate verifiable framework and justifiable curriculum as per our National Curriculum Framework 2005 with my dear students. It is the inborn right and uncompromising constitutional right of my dear students and my beloved children to receive verifiable certain knowledge and justifiable valid knowledge free from all established fallacies, particularly subjective self-contradictions and objective paradoxes. In this connection, a few contradictories or rival hypotheses, that is, identified anti-natural and unscientific hypotheses, objectively present within the framework and curriculum of natural science and searched out natural sciences, are being placed before authorities from the local level to the United Nations seeking constitutional remedies for the identified issues as per our National Curriculum Framework 2005, RTE Act, Right to Education Act 2009, CRC, International Convention on the Rights of the Child, and UN General Assembly 2002. Concerned authorities from the local level, including our Honorable Education Minister of Assam, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, to the United Nations, including Secretary General of United Nations, are honestly requested to take necessary steps or to make necessary arrangements with a view to provide us recognized confirmation of natural science as per science education in correspondence to reality mentioned in page 27 of our National Curriculum Framework 2005, ensured quality education mentioned in section 29 of the RTE Act 2009, necessary humanistic vision of education mentioned in the article 29 of CRC, and a world fit for children adopted on UN General Assembly 2002. I shall remain thankful to the concerned authorities from the local level to the United Nations forever for the same. I am concluding my second lecture on antinatural and unscientific hypothesis, wishing concerned authorities from the local level to the United Nations all the best, and thanking you all.